Independence and freedom allowed new opportunities for people. Through the next few decades, a lot of progress was made. But differences between the North and the South grew, and a full-fledged war erupted. The Civil War, fought on our very own soil, pitting brother against brother, was tearing us further and further apart. But on a cold November afternoon in 1863, Abraham Lincoln delivered a two-minute speech dedicating the Soldiers' National Cemetery in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. His words, now regarded as one of the greatest speeches in American history, redefined the Civil War as a struggle, not merely for the Union, but for a new birth of freedom for all citizens. We may never know how the President's speech would have inspired the outcome of the war, but few can dispute the power of the right words spoken at the right time.
Fourscore and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation, or any nation so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate. We cannot consecrate. We cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note, nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be dedicated here to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, and for the people, should not perish from the earth.